Hello, welcome to Soiled Mirror. I'm your hostess, Betty St. Laveau. On this show, we talk about film theory, film history, movies, and actors, and let's get right to it. Firstly, I would like to thank Orca, Jen, Zach, Chris, Sean, and everyone else who has helped me with my show, and I tend to forget that. Plus, I'd like to thank Kellogg Hubbard Library and Wikipedia, too, because you all helped me out with my notes. And today, Wikipedia is especially going to help me out because we are doing list of films with 100% rating on Rotten Tomatoes. Now, I usually pay no attention to what other reviewers are talking about, but this Rotten Tomatoes thing is a thing, and it's something I'd like to address. I had no idea that they had this type of rating. I'm glad that they do, and I'm glad that some of the movies I adore are on this list. So I'm going to very briefly not touch every single movie, but the movies I happen to like, and I'll give you a tiny fact about every movie, and I will give you a reason why I think that you should watch it. Okay, so let's get started. The first movie is Nanook of the North. It was made in 1922. This is your typical film class movie. Almost every professor I've ever had has, a film professor, has thrown this movie at me. It's a documentary. Some of the scenes were manufactured, but it is the first famous known documentary, and I enjoy it. Some of it, a clip of it shows up in Black Widow with Teresa Russell and Deborah Winger. And it's very eerily done when they show the clip. And I believe it is from Nanook of the North. So please just check it out as a good film when you're studying documentary film history. The next film is Battleship Potemkin. This is Sergei Eisenstein's masterpiece. It was made in 1925. And I first saw this when I was 12. It affected me very deeply, especially for its use of montage in the movie. And that montage is a definition where the person is looking at something and then another, some action is inserted. So you're thinking that the person's looking at the action, but they're not. At any rate, beautiful, disturbing movie, and it set during the Russian Revolution of 1917. The next movie is Un Chien d'Angelou, co-written by Salvador Dali and Louis Brunel. It is a shockingly good surrealist masterpiece, and it was made in 1929. It's one of my favorite movies for many different reasons. The use of symbolism is prevalent and very pungently so. I would suggest you check it out if you're interested in surrealistic art. The next movie is M, 1931, Fritz Lang, who is a genius of German Expressionism. It stars Peter Lorre, and I would like you all to watch the subtitle version. Please watch the German and do the subtitles. It was later remade, and I'm trying to think of the actor, but I think it was remade in 1949. Check that out. Check out M first, and then check out the remake. Next, we have Public Enemy. This is one of James Cagney's piece de resistance. I love this movie for so many reasons, and I especially love the family. Well, White Heat is also his piece of resistance, but Public Enemy is about crime, family, loyalty, betrayal, and trust. It's got a lot in it, and it has a very it's almost misogynistic in its treatment of women. It has a very famous scene where he's shoving a grapefruit, I believe, in Mae Murray's face, and Jean Harlow is in it. But the film, the exposition's awesome. Now, we're going to go down the list a little bit. I see Captain Blood, which starred Errol Flynn, that was made in 1935. The original A Star Is Born, made in 1937, starring Janet Gaynor and Frederick March. What a beautiful movie. It's a heart-wrenching tearjerker. If you ever feel the need to just relax and cry, check it out. I'm going to go on down to Sovereign's Travels. This is Preston Sturges. It's a movie about Hollywood, and it stars Joel McCrea and Veronica Lake. It was made in 1941. This is seen to be believed. The exposition in the script is exquisite. Let's go on down to Laura, Otto Preminger's movie made in 1944 with Gene Tierney, Clifton Webb, Dana Andrews, Vincent Price, Judith Anderson, and somebody else that I'm forgetting off the top of my head. Gene Tierney. How can I forget Ms. Tierney? Okay. The penultimate romantic murder mystery. Go on down the list a little bit more. We've got I Vitelloni, made in 1953 by Federico Fellini. It's a awesome movie about growing up in a town. It's a coming of age movie set in Italy, and y'all would like it a lot. Seven Samurai. I recently touched upon this movie on St. Louis World Cinema. We will go more in depth about that movie when we study Akira Kurosawa on the same show, the director. Going down the list, there's Night and Fog, which I watched at Antioch College. It was made in 1956. Documentary film about the Holocaust. If we go down a little bit more. We are hitting the 60s now. We went through the 50s quite a bit. Now, I have not seen Le Samurai with Alain Delon, and I have not seen Cool Hand Luke yet. Le Samurai with Alain Delon was made in 1967, as was Cool Hand Luke with Paul Newman and George Kennedy. Going on down the list a little bit more, we have Atlantic City with Susan Sarandon and Burt Lancaster. It was made in 1980. I watched that movie and when it first came out on TV, and I didn't mind it one bit. I've been waiting for a long time to watch it. I can't exactly remember the details of the plot, but Susan Sarandon plays a card dealer, and Burt Lancaster is her neighbor who peeps in on her from across the way through a window. Going down the list a little bit more. We're in the 90s now, and I can't really see anything. Now we're in the 2010s. Now we're in the 20 teens. Haven't really seen a lot of good ones, I think, but, and some of these are independent, I believe. So we're going right on down. We keep on going. Haven't seen any of these. 2018. Keeping going down. Yep. I guess I haven't seen very many 100% ratings of Rotten Tomatoes in the present decade. So we keep on going, present century. Going down. Nope, can't see anything. Yep. Yep, just can't. So it seems like I have a lot of catching up to do when it comes to movies that all the at least 27, 45 critics, 22 critics. There has to be a certain amount of critics to agree that it's a movie that's 100%. So I'll go back a little bit, and I still really can't find anything. So I think that I'm stuck in the 80s with Atlantic City. Some of the, pardon me, there's the Terminator 1984. That movie is flawless. So at least I'm in the 80s a little bit. Oh, And then we come to Vagabond. I'm so sorry, Agnes Varda. Vagabond is one of the most beautiful movies in the world. It is an incredible, incredible movie. It's about a female vagabond who travels through France without a clue to what she's doing, where she's going, and she doesn't care about no one. And back, you know, when you're in your 20s or 30s, maybe in your 20s, you think about hitting the road and just being free of all responsibilities. And let me tell you something, our responsibilities and our limitations actually set us free. It's when we have limitations that we are able to learn and care for other people. So that movie Vagabond, Agnes Varda's movie, that is a masterpiece it's a movie that teaches us that we must have a moral center in order to be a part of a community and to succeed in life. So that's it for me today. I'm Betty St. Laveau. You've been watching Celluloid Mirror here at Orca. I want to thank the Orca crew again, Jen, Zach, Chris, and Sean, for helping me with my show, and everyone through the years. I've been talking about movies since about 2002 on various stations, and despite the fact that there's a backlash with celebrity culture, movies are awesome. There's just something about all types of literature that elevate the human experience. And I think watching a movie and making a movie is one of them. And again, to everyone who's ever made any movie in Hollywood or all over the world, you techies, help us out. Because if it weren't for us, for all y'all techies, the actors and the writers would have a hard time translating their vision into art. Okay, until next time, y'all, you stay away from those bad movies. Ciao.